There are many different ways to orient a PV array. On flat roofs or in fields, typically systems will consist of rows of tilted panels. In PVsyst, we refer to these rows as sheds. In this video, we'll explore some theory around neutral shading in shed-based systems. We'll start by defining a shed and some important design parameters for sheds. Then we will explore the topic of ground coverage ratio. We will then use the PVsyst near shadings tool to explain the concepts of profile angle and the shading limit angle. Finally, we will touch on the optimization of shed-based systems. In French, the word shed refers to sawtooth roof patterns used on factories like this one. This pattern is the same as the one used for photovoltaic panels on flat surfaces. So in PVsyst, we use this term shed to describe rows of sawtooth patterned solar panels. Let's look at the main design parameters for such a system. The first is the length of the module and its mounting structure. In PVsyst, we split this into three partitions. The active area of the module that contains solar cells is called the collector band. Then there are the inactive parts, both above and below the collector band. Next, there is the orientation of the rows. Just as with other fixed tilted plane systems, the tilt angle and the azimuth define the orientation. To simplify things, we can assume that all the sheds have the same orientation. Finally, there is the pitch. The pitch is defined as the distance from the base of one row of modules to the next row of modules. Normally, the length of the module will be fixed based on the choice of the module. And in most cases, the azimuth of the system will be set to face the equator for optimal energy yield. In this case, the key parameters we need to set are thus the tilt angle and the pitch. There are many considerations for deciding the appropriate tilt angle and pitch, which include generation efficiency, ease of access, and cost. However, from solely an energy yield perspective, we must consider two important aspects of our system: ground coverage ratio and mutual shading. The ground coverage ratio, or GCR, is defined as a ratio between the active PV area of our system and the total area of the ground occupation of that same system. Normally, the ground occupation is constant, such as the area of a flat roof or the area of a field where a PV system will be built. So if we decrease the pitch, we can fit more panels in our site, which increases our active area. This will increase our GCR. The lower our pitch, the more sheds we can fit into a given area. Since we are considering a perfectly regular shed-based system, the GCR can be approximated by the ratio of the module length to the pitch. However, we have to also consider mutual shading. Mutual shading refers to the shading of one shed of panels by another shed. To account for this, it is important to understand how to calculate the size of the shadow of a shed. We can show this quite well using the scene construction tool in PVsyst. Here you can see two rows of panels with one stemming from the origin. These rows are both oriented towards the south with a tilt angle of 30 degrees. To start, let's consider the case when the sun is directly facing the PV modules, which means the sun azimuth is zero. Looking at the side view of our system, you can see a red line representing the sun path to the origin. The angle between this path and the horizontal from this perspective is referred to as the profile angle. In the case of the sun being positioned directly in front of the solar panels, the profile angle is equal to the solar elevation angle. If we move our panel to touch the red line, this will be the limit for mutual shading with these panels. If the sun is any lower, then one row will shade the other. We can show this by moving the sun to a lower angle. Now you can see that mutual shading occurs. Let's move the sun back to the same elevation as before. This represents the shallowest profile angle where no mutual shading occurs. We refer to this angle in PVsyst as the shading limit angle. The shading limit angle depends on the pitch and orientation of our sheds. So if we had panels with this orientation and pitch, we would say that the shading limit angle is 30 degrees. While this angle is equal to the elevation angle when the sun is directly in front of the panel, this changes at other sun azimuths. Changing the azimuth here, you can see from the perspective view that the shading depth has changed even though the solar elevation has stayed the same. If we go back to the side view, you can see that now there is a different profile angle. Understanding the concept of shading limit angle will be important for using the shed optimization tool in PVsyst. So again, the profile angle is defined as the angle between the horizontal plane and the plane that includes the sun and the line perpendicular to the azimuth of the module. The shading limit angle is the smallest profile angle possible for a given set of row parameters where no mutual shading occurs. The smaller the shading limit angle, the less mutual shading there will be throughout the year. So keeping in mind the shading limit angle, we can start to discuss optimization. Optimization of these systems is not trivial. If we're only maximizing for energy yield for a given area, horizontal panels placed next to each other would achieve that for us. However, this would not be practical for accessing the PV modules, and it would make for a very expensive system, as each panel would produce a smaller energy yield than if they were optimally tilted. If we tilt our panels, then there is always a trade-off between GCR and the shading limit angle. Maximizing GCR and minimizing the shading limit angle is preferable, but these two goals are in conflict with each other. Going deep into this optimization is outside the scope of this course. It depends on the design goals for the system, whether that be energy production, cost, or something else. However, PVsyst has some tools that help with this, depending on your design decision. This will be the topic of the next tutorial. In this video, we discussed some important considerations when designing a PV system using sheds. We discussed the main design parameters for sheds and showed the interplay between ground coverage ratio and mutual shading. Next, we will show you how to use the unlimited shed tool to make a first approximation when designing such systems.